it is one of the most common problems that people have with their feet. There are more than 3 million U.S. cases per year. We are talking about bunions. And here to talk to us about prevention and the latest treatment is Dr. Aaron Dean from Crystal Clinic Orthopedic Center. So we have an orthopedic surgeon here discussing a very, I mean, this is, again, a very common,
very common
thing.
Very common.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's all different kinds, I'm assuming, as far as the severity goes.
Absolutely, absolutely. Bunions can start very mild and can progress to very severe and sometimes even affect the other toes or the rest of your foot as well. Absolutely.
So what technically, what is a bunion? How does it form?
Sure. A bunion occurs when the inside part of the big toe starts to get more prominent. The big toe starts to drift over towards the lesser toes, the second toe, and can cause problems with rubbing on shoes and irritation of the joint and pain in the toes.
Mm-hmm. Is it more common in one sex than the other, or who sees it the most and when? I'm guessing more elderly people will see it, or?
As you progress in age, yes, it can definitely occur more commonly. Women tend to experience it more commonly than males as well.
Yeah. Now, when it comes to, it can be very painful, I'm assuming, once they get to a certain degree.
Mm-hmm.
As far as surgery goes, is there easy fixes?
Well, every surgery has its risks and benefits, and there's not necessarily an easy surgery versus a hard surgery, but surgery can be very helpful for bunions, absolutely, yeah. And there are different amounts of work that have to be done based on the severity of the bunion.
Mm-hmm. When you have surgery, because I'm sure there might be someone out there thinking, I have them, mm-hmm. I've been nervous to have the surgery. I'm sure every person's different, but what is normally the recovery process?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so fixing a bunion usually involves cutting the bone in a couple different places at times and aligning the joint in a better position. So surgery involves being in a boot usually or a post-op shoe for about 6 weeks or so and limiting activity for that time period as well. But usually I have people up walking during the recovery process fairly quickly, which is nice.
Mm-hmm. Is it case by case then if you would suggest surgery versus maybe over-the-counter, maybe medicine?
Absolutely, it depends on the severity and it depends on the patient themselves as well. It depends on medical problems and such. There are definitely things you can try short of surgery. There are different toe spacers and padding that you can do. Shoe modifications, making sure you have a nice wide roomy shoe can help. But yeah, other patients are good surgical candidates and go that route.
Now there are different levels of severity here, so I'm guessing
yes.
You start off with a very mild case.
Mm-hmm.
Is that barely recognizable if someone were to look at a foot?
Yeah, you can get a little bit of a mild bump there, and with certain shoes that can be irritating, and then it can certainly progress where the bump gets larger and rubs more on the shoes. And then it can become more severe where it actually starts to bother the other toes as well. And sometimes you end up with the second toe crossing over the first toe and then the second toe can rub on the shoes.
So if someone is dealing with this issue now, I'm guessing the first thing would be to give you guys a call,
mm-hmm.
and schedule an appointment. Do you do an evaluation with
Absolutely.
Someone?
X-rays, evaluation, looking at the foot and talking to the patient about what's bothering them and what we can do to address it.
Mm-hmm. What if someone is, I mean, do you ever get them in younger adults?
Oh, absolutely.
Or what's the youngest patient you've seen?
You can have juvenile bunions.
Wow.
Yeah,
okay.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And kids up to teenagers, absolutely.
Well, mm-hmm. if it's an issue you're dealing with, because again, as we just heard, millions of people deal with this, give them a call at the Crystal Clinic. Great orthopedic surgeons there to help you out. Thank you so much for being
with
us
thank
today.
You. Thank you.
New Day Cleveland continues after this short break.